Everybody, today I am going to do a video that I have been planning on doing for a very long time, and it is that time of year again where the new year is right around the corner, and therefore I want to talk about planning to organize your new day planner and doing some journaling in order to make it really interesting and something that you're going to be enjoying to use every single day, because after all, it is something that is going to be needed on a daily basis just to keep things on track for you in your planning and to make you a lot more organized. And I have found that when you use a day planner, that is exactly what happens. If you use it every single day and kind of use it as if it is a journal, then you can really keep track of all of your appointments, all of the things that you have scheduled, all of the ideas that you have that you want to do, just anything in general that you think that is really important to jot down in a day planner can keep you really, really organized. And then that way, you don't forget anything. And if you're like me, there's so much going on in your life, which I'm pretty sure that's everybody's life. So if you write it down in your day planner, then you know you can keep track of your work, you can keep track of your bills, you can keep track of when you get paid. It just keeps things really neat and concise. And one of the ways that I do that is by using color coding and therefore obviously different colored pens. So I'm going to show you that in just a moment. But for those of you that have been following me for a while, and you might have remembered my last year's day planner organization video, I do believe I did it in two parts because I had taken a day planner that I picked up at Staples last year, and the cover wasn't exactly what I wanted it to be, so I painted it and recreated it into something that I felt really, really comfortable with and I wanted to work with. And this is it, for those of you that recall the finished product. This is the front of it, this is the back, and as you can see, it is totally stuffed to the gills with all kinds of notes and just, my gosh, there's all kinds of stuff going on in here. And we're in the final month now, December. It's December 1st today when I'm filming this video. And so therefore, we're in the final month of the year, and it is definitely time to get into getting ready for a new day planner. So, with that being said, this year, I figured that I would look for something a little bit different. I've been using the same style of day planner from Staples for the last 3, maybe 4 years, and I wanted to do something a little bit different. So, this time, I went shopping at Barnes & Noble. And here's the little bag, Barnes & Noble, that I came home with. And I decided this year that I was going to pick up two items. One of them was a new day planner, and the other is a journal. And the journal that I picked up is something that I'm going to use probably for art journaling. Maybe cutting out pictures from magazines and different old books, or things that I might find from cards that, I don't know, anything that's inspirational to me, and that is going to go in my art journal for the year of 2015. But I first want to show you my new day planner, and I am so super excited about this. This is what it looks like. It is a beautiful, beautiful book, and it is called Artisan, well, it's from the Artisan Collection by Lang, and it has this little band right here so you can keep it all together. But on the front and on the back, I haven't even taken the sticker off yet, it has this gorgeous metallic-y butterfly pattern. And when you open it up inside, it has this gorgeous, and I don't even want to spread the pages yet because I am just not ready to do that. It's just so new and perfect right now. But as you can see, they're very pretty and marbled inside with kind of a, I want to say, like a very vintage, not chambray, but what is the word I'm looking for? Damask. That's the word, damask pattern inside. And then, if you will, you'll have the 2015 and 2016 month calendars. And then each page has a full month spread. So for example, this is January, and there's enough room in here that you can go ahead and put little notes. And then after each month comes the next month. So it goes through the 12 months consecutively, January, February, etc., etc., into December. And then once you finish up with the month spread, the next pages are the weekly planning pages. So, with that being said, it starts here, where you can jot down your little notes about what's going on, and it gives you a little bit more room for detail. The other neat thing about this is that each page, and I'm going to zoom in a little bit here, each page has a little tiny perforated tab, so if you want to use that, you can, so that you can retrieve by using your thumb, by going down here with your thumb and retrieving the page a little bit more easily. Now, I don't have with me today any decorative paper clips or anything like that to share with you, but I probably will be using some colored, decorative paper clips because I like to collect those, and I think that'll help keep my pages organized too. So, for example, once we're in the month of January, I will have a clip on January's page, and then I will also have a clip on January in the notes section. So the notes section actually starts with December 29th, which is kind of cool. So you can finish out the last couple of days in December with your notes and then go right into January with your monthly pages. So then you have your notes all the way where you can, you know, your daily planning all the way to the end of December 2016. And then after that, I thought this was so cool. It has a page for the zodiac, so you can see what zodiac signs are when. And that's really cool because even though I'm very familiar with the zodiacs, it is something that I always like to refresh on and kind of revisit. And so I thought it was really cool that the zodiac and birthstones are listed in the back of my day planner. Then the other thing it has is a page for just regular notes, and I do believe that, oh yeah, just one page of that. No, I apologize. It has one page of notes, and then it has several pages for contacts, where you can write down names, addresses, and phone numbers and such, and that's always nice. Even though everybody keeps everything in their phone, it seems, and a lot of people use their phone as their day planner, a lot of people like to still write things down, and I'm one of those people. So I really enjoy having a day planner that gives me the accessibility to be able to do those sorts of things. And then it continues through the end of the book with just other pages and more notes. So that is really cool. And once again, in the back, it has the beautiful marbled damask pattern. Now, what I might do, and I haven't decided yet, but I'm probably going to also use some beautiful bookmarkers inside this, and I may use the bookmarkers instead of the decorative paper clips. Haven't decided yet, or I might use both, so we'll see. If anybody's interested, please let me know. As I get into using my day planner, I would be more than happy to share with you how I have decided to kind of map out each page. I've even considered putting a little pocket in the back here. So I might do that too, so that I can stick little pieces of paper in that might be loose instead of keeping them all crazy like this one where I have all kinds of papers just like flying around in there and receipts and stuff like that. It's just like nuts. Yeah. See that? It's crazy. So I might decide to put a little pocket and organize myself just a little bit more. Now, in order to color code, I picked up these really cute ink pens, and these are by Papermate. They're called Ink Joy, and they're effortless writing pens, as it says. And it comes with a black one, an orange one, a red one, a pink one, a purple one, two shades of blue and a green, and this is what they look like. So with this, I'm really planning on color coding and using these pens to keep me even more organized inside my day planner. What I'll probably do is prepare some sort of a key inside. There's really no room in the beginning, but when it gets back to the end where there's a note page, right here, I might start the first note page and use it as a key for my color coding. And then that way, it's just kind of a reminder. As I get into working my day planner for the year of 2015, I will just know what pen goes with what. But it's always nice to have a color-coded key in the back or in the front of your book so that you can have that as a reference. Okay, now moving right along. Oh, one last thing. Let me backtrack. I did share this with you, this little band here. So this is really nice because as you get going and you have little papers and such stuffed inside here, you can keep it kind of together because what it does is it just keeps everything in like that. And I do believe this particular book, let me see if my receipt is inside here still. No, I took the receipt out. I think this book was like anywhere from either $8.99. Oh, you know what? I have my glasses right here. I was going to say between $8.99 and $12.99. It was $12.99. And this particular one is called the Bohemian Butterflies 2015 Engagement Planner by the Artisan Collections by Lang. It's an engagement planner with 12-month format, monthly and weekly planning, contact and note pages, as I said. So the artwork inside is by Susan Wingett. And I just think it's really lovely. Let me see if there's any other artwork in here. Not really. It's just pretty much basic once you get into the book. But I just think the butterflies are so gorgeous. I love the bohemian style. Those of you that follow me already know that about me. So I thought it was just perfect. And I'm really happy about having this particular day planner this year because last year, I took a lot of time in designing my own, which was really fun, but this year, my world is kind of hectic with a lot of things going on between my band and my Etsy boutique, with my art business, my jewelry business, my magical creations that I make, and just I've got so much going on that it's really nice to have found a day planner that's already created that I don't have to worry about yet another project to do. So that's really cool. Now, speaking of art, I also picked up at Barnes & Noble this gorgeous journal that says Love Who You Are. Look how beautiful this is. So gorgeous. And it has the same photo on the back. It's a spiral notebook, and inside, oh my God, look how lovely this is. This is just so amazing. As I said, I'm pretty sure I'm going to keep this as an art journal for inspiration, but I'm not sure yet. I seem to say that in a lot of different videos, that I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it yet, but it is the truth. Usually what happens is it just evolves. So each page is just absolutely lovely. Here's an example. Love who you are. On this page it says. And then there's just different beautiful pages. This one's in pink. Then we have yellow. Oh my gosh, just beautiful flowers, gorgeous roses. Which is what I'm so into. Roses and peonies is what it looks like. So it's just gorgeous. Absolutely and totally in love with this. And this is the back. And I love it because it's a really thick cardboard, cardstock album or journal, if you will. And I'm really looking forward to using this year. I can't wait to get into it. I just really can't. I think I might even write some poetry in here. And it seems like a lot of times I'm just jotting down lyrics for possible songs. So I might just I might just use it for that. I have a lot of pages that I've already written on that are just pieces of paper that I've jotted lyrics down on for possible songs that our band is going to be doing, and I don't know, I might just add it to this or just start fresh with new inside here. So there's a lot that I can do with this. I'm really happy about this one too. I got this one at Barnes & Noble also, and this one was also $12.95. So I think I picked up some really beautiful things this year to start the year out in 2015. Really anxious about getting into planning the new year, and I would love to hear what you have going on for your day planners. I would love to see a video response of what you have decided to use as your day planner or even a journal for the new year. And please do think about making a video on that and sending me the link. I would love to see it, really. That would be so cool if those of you that watch my videos decided to do a video response to share with me what you think is really awesome to keep you organized for the new year. So with that being said, I know this has been a little bit long-winded, but it's really late at night. It's December 1st, and it is 1:39 in the morning, and I am just about getting ready to go to bed. I'm having my nightly ritual cup of tea and just enjoying some quiet time here in my house, and thought that I would share a few things with you. So thanks for being here with me today, or tonight, shall I say. It's really today. It's morning. I really appreciate you being with me. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, I will see you in my next video. Many blessings. Bye.